Since last week, Sri Lanka's daily COVID cases have been on a steady rise. Daily COVID cases, which were once reported at under 100 at the start of this month, have now reached the 700 range as of last evening. Health authorities believe that public behavior over the past few weeks could be the cause for the recent spike. Health authorities also warn that any continuation of this phenomenon could lead to drastic measures being implemented to stem any possible future waves. With that, speaking at a media briefing today, consultant community physician at the Family Health Bureau, Dr. Kapila Jayaratne, emphasized the importance of public responsibility in preventing COVID deaths.
පසුගිය සතිය දිහා බලපුවාම කොවිඩ් නිසා වූ මරණ 130 150 අතර ප්‍රමාණයක්. දැඩි සත්කාර වල ඉන්නවා තවමත් 75කට ආසන්න සංඛ්‍යාව. අපි ඒකයි කියන්නේ වසංගතය ඉවර නැහැ. තාමත් ක්‍රියාකාරී. අපිට සියල්ල අතහැර නිකන් ඉන්නට බෑ. මේ වන විට 14,000ක් ජනතාව මිය ගිහින් තියෙනවා. මෙතන ඉන්නවා වැඩි හිටියෝ, ගර්භණී මව්වරු 60ක් ඉන්නවා. අපේ දරුවෝ 78ක් ඉන්නවා. මේවා නිකම්ම නිකන් සංඛ්‍යා නෙමෙයි. මේ සංඛ්‍යා තුල තියෙන ජීවිත. ඒ හැම දෙයකටම අපි හැම දෙනාම වග කියන්නේ.
Despite the pleas by health officials for people to avoid gatherings in large numbers, their advice seems to have fallen on deaf ears, despite warnings that such actions only serve to compromise current pandemic effort gains.
මීට පෙර උගත් පාඩම් තිබියදී අතිවිශාල පිරිසක් සහභාගී වීම පිළිබඳව අපිට කනගාටුවක් තමයි ප්‍රකාශ කරන්න තියෙන්නේ. මොකද ඊයේ සිදු වුණ දෙයි ප්‍රතිඵල අපි දකින්නේ තව දවස් 10කින් 15කින්. ඉල්ලා සිටින්නේ මෙවැනි ක්‍රියාවලිය වලට යෙදෙන්න එපා. අපි තවම ඉන්නේ දැඩි අවදානම් තත්වයක.
With this being the case, the Ministry of Health warns that if the country's COVID cases continue to surge, the first move taken by health officials would be to close schools once again. This comes in a backdrop where grades 1 to 5 and the O-level and A-level grades have resumed school activities, while measures have been taken to resume schools for students of grades 6 to 9 from next Monday.
There are reports related to the increased number of cases among the students and teachers in different parts of the country. And this is not an isolated happening. Basically, this reflects the increased number of cases in various parts of the island where the new cases are being reported. And most of the time, when the students are affected, when the teachers are affected, their family members are also affected. And as a result, there can be increased number of cases reporting from those parts of the country. If there is any further deterioration of the situation, the first thing probably would have been done is to close the schools, and that will definitely deprive our children's school life.
Close up Everfresh toothpaste. Pe dolak dakwa nevum muvaka pasa atvidinna.